Why do you want to leave modeling and come here? Modeling has more money, more glamour. Go and make a career in modeling. What is left in IAS? The faithless service. That and how you can do what you do. You go and tell her what.
First is you need to sit
a
little straighter. You slouch when you sit.
Okay.
That's just like a body language thing, normal. That happens with tall people. Tall people, they tend to slouch a little. So just sit a little straight. That will help one thing. Second, you have to be very careful with the words that you're using.
Okay.
In the interview. So like for example, beech mein in that whole conversation that you were having in ma'am, you just put Islamic State out of nowhere. You know? So that is something that should not have come up. Okay. And with the things that you're saying in your answer also, you have to be a little calculative of what you're saying. You cannot be saying anything and everything. Reason being, like I did not even have stone pelting in my head. I did not even have major go-go in my head. But because you said it, that whole instance came to me and then you got it. So be a little more calculative as to what you say. Otherwise you're articulate, you're well-spoken, you're confident, you keep your points firmly. All that is there. And hoping you've done well in means, you'll do well in the interview also. But just keep these couple of things in mind.
Okay. First thing I had is like when you're asked a question by me, so you're responding to me. So I don't know, a little eye contact should be there with the rest of the members because like if she's talking to you, I get very disinterested because it's one-way contact. So there'll be a board sitting, so like there'll be five members. So I think you should have a little eye contact. Look at others too, because you're not just responding to her, the board is listening to you. When there are people listening to you, just a little, of course you would be looking at her most of the time too, but you can just, and the person who is asking you. That is one thing. Then with respect to the issues, like, so you find, like, like whatever she said to don't get into the trap, you come out of the trap also nicely, so that is not the problem, because you can talk in a way that you can put forth your points. But then fundamentally, there are some issues where I feel like, because one point where you were caught is regarding human rights only, with that Gogoi thing. When you said at one answer, you said in AFSPA that human rights internally they can take care of. Then within that also, you only gave the content. I didn't know what is the percentage of conviction. She herself said that 6% the conviction of that, which I'm not aware of. But you said human rights they'll take care of, and then you only countered your own point that they take care of but they don't convict. So when there are no convictions, means they're not taking care of to the extent that they should. So that was a point where you yourself are giving away points, and in Gogoi case again, that was a human rights violation.
What was the
evidence?
Evident violation by human rights.
So if you defend that also, then again you are showing that army can do anything kind of. So what? थोड़ा वो स्टैंड्स में थोड़ा प्रॉब्लम है
थोड़ा सा क्योंकि यू नो मे बी कर्व डाउन ऑफ द एडमिन दैट्स फाइन दैट्स टोटली फाइन सी द थिंग इज दैट इट्स हाउ यू प्रेजेंट योरसेल्फ देयर सो दैट वे थोड़ा लिटिल बिट ऑन द इफ आइदर यू डोंट यू नो यू कैन डू आई थिंक बी लाइक आई सेड बी अ लिटिल मोर कैलकुलेटिव व्हेन यू स्पीक बिकॉज़ इन अदर इश्यूज
शी गिव्स
पॉइंट्स अबाउट हूज पॉइंट
शी गिव्स पॉइंट्स लाइक इवन आई डिडंट पिक दैट अप बिकॉज़ आई डिडंट वांट टू स्ट्रेच इट शी स्पोक ऑफ फंडामेंटलिज्म विद रिस्पेक्ट टू दैट आल्सो एंड इन दैट फंडामेंटलिज्म आई रिमेंबर ही सेइंग दैट इवन चिल्ड्रन आर बीइंग रैडिकलाइज्ड दे शुड बी सेपरेट camps or something for them, de-radicalization camps was the suggestion being given for children. So that was a point which we would not have asked, but you put forth fundamentalism.
Even Islamic State as such would have been a whole
discussion. These are controversial things and your viewpoints are in favor of them, is what is evident. If you are against them and you speak about it, and wo thoda problematic, you are only putting forth those points. What do you think about that too? They should be done, of course. I
don't agree with that.
General Bipin Rawat, he spoke of de-radicalization camps for children because they are being brainwashed. So you don't agree with that?
No.
That
is there, but thoda sa bees will be done.
Ma'am, it's just that there are certain issues like Major Gogoi case.
Huh.
So like my father, he knows about that case.
Right.
So when the inquiry happened, like he was there. So like, whatever his inputs that he has given me, like I speak from that point of view.
Right, right. That is evident.
So maybe that's why I.
That is in Afghanistan also. That is evident.
Ma'am, that with every person who has an army background or a naval background will have something. Even I have something like that. It's just that over time we have become more diplomatic as to what to speak in a civil setting.
Yes.
And there is a sort of a this thing between the army and the civil services, you know, this sort of tug of war that is going. So when you speak there, you have to speak as if you are sitting in a civil setting, because I'm sure you're more used to sitting in a Fauji setting, right?
Yes.
So thoda sa if you think about sitting in a civil setting and taking care of their opinion, then it will come. With time, we were also like that, just that with time, getting used to the civil crowd so much, our opinions have toned down a little, or maybe we've become diplomatic while, you know, talking about.
She tried to be diplomatic by saying ke sab sahi hai, lekin human rights violation hi hona chahiye. Yeah, main wo ek add kar do ke sab sahi hai, aap bhi sab sahi kar rahe hai, but human rights violation hi hona. That was your kind of being diplomatic, but it did not work because overall you gave those inputs. So, okay. Then about your armed forces also, like I was not happy with the points for. So when you are giving, like sir said that he asked you to give for and against both points. So when you gave for points, so I didn't find much substance in that. Like I don't know, because like society, then you again your for points like saying society decide karna chahiye, uncomfortable hoga. So the, all that, let it be. Like if the woman is uncomfortable, let it be. Like if you are, suppose you are on one side of the debate, would you think you would win with such points that you say that women will be uncomfortable when I say on the other side that no, let the woman decide if she is comfortable or not. Why should we take away that opportunity? So in such a debate, if you are on four side, on this side, would you like to lose or would you have substantial points to win on that side?
Ma'am, since sir asked me to give both the sides, so like I had to talk
because
about
this
the
is this comes up in civil services too. You should have points on either side and points which should make you win, make your answer stand out, because if questions are asked in UPSC also, substantiate or something on some point which you may not agree on. So do you think your points were good enough to make it a winning answer or winning in a debate?
No, ma'am, I think I'd have to work on that.
Because your counterpoints were against that only, so
counterpoints were better.
So that's what they were against that. So they worked.
Counterpoints were what I believed in, and the other points were to sort of give.
And about economic slowdown, this was very bookish answer, like global, cyclical, structural. This is like sab static. Kabhi kabhi answer aap abhi de sakte ho. Abhi jab ho raha hai, us pe aap fresh inputs if you give what's going on right now, that would help. Like this is any time, even in 2016 koi puchta economic ke liye kya karo, to aap bologe global, cyclical, structural. Wo hamesha hota hai. Lekin abhi jo issue hai, so you should have more substantial points to talk
your
about.
Your answers have to be more to the point. Sometimes something else is asked when you're saying something else.
Okay.
So thoda bahut be very careful about what you're speaking, because puchha kuch hota hai, quick jobs, I cannot recollect the question.
When it was asked about private and public,
yeah,
non-performing assets, public mein zyada problem hai, private mein kam hai. Aap in general aage ki RBI dono ko regulate kare, wo ab ye batao na NPA kyun hai, NPA public mein zyada kyun, uska answer aapne nahi diya. NPA is
not to the point, like
that
agar A pucha hai to A hi batana, not B, C and D. Right, so that point has to be
like there. You spoke on NPAs in general, if you remember. You didn't speak on why NPAs are more in public sector than private.
See, I've been a part of interview board, civil services interview board. What I have observed is that you know, when we get a bright candidate, we tend to ask difficult questions. So many members would like to unsettle you.
Okay, sir.
Like somebody will say, why do you want to leave modeling and come here? Modeling has more money, more glamour. Go and make a career in modeling. What is left in IAS? The faceless service. So these type of questions they may ask. Then again, you have to come up with what you said. You know, that opportunity to do for the society, what inspires you for the UPSC civil services is the opportunity that it will provide to make a difference as you rightly said. So you don't have to get unsettled, because you expect that a lot of people will try to ask very difficult questions from you
regarding this modeling background,
from the hobbies. you have written this Pilates. How do you pronounce it?
Pilates.
Now somebody will say, why this? Why not yoga? Who founded this? Who started this form of exercise? You tell me.
Joseph Pilates.
Why he started it?
So it was started in post 1945, sir, post World War, when the soldiers, they were injured and they could not move. So that time this sort of exercise was discovered, invented by Joseph Pilates to essentially rehabilitate them.
So somebody will say, why do you want to follow this foreign thing? Why not yoga? Why not desi?
Practice yoga.
Somebody will try to answer.
I never learned yoga. Never get that
opportunity. It's okay.
Questions would come to me.
You should not
answer.
You should not get uncertain. This is what I say, because you accept very difficult questions from the board. Because it is our tendency to ask difficult questions from a candidate who is above average, or who is exceptional, or who is bright. So we can make out from the background whether somebody is bright or not bright. You look at the academics or the form will tell you if somebody is bright or not bright. And supposing you are, as we make out you are bright, we will ask very difficult questions from you, and especially from the economics. Because today economy is, there will be different views on economy. So you prepare very well on, I would suggest that you read this Economic Times and Business Standard almost on a day-to-day basis, like a religion, like a religious book, because you are going to be asked mostly on economy. Because everybody is concerned about economy, whether a member or a person on the street. So economy and the hobbies, you have to prepare quite well. And of course, all these things, supposing somebody asks you something, you don't know. You say you don't know, because when I went for the interview, somebody said, have you heard of Pakhawaj? I said, no. Pakhawaj is a form of the music. I said, no, I have not. Have you played tabla? I said, no. Then he says, do you play cricket? I said, no. He kept on asking things which I didn't know. So he kept on saying, no. So it's not that he is trying to find out what you don't know, but he is trying to find out how you react to a situation, whether you get unnerved. No. Because there are thousands of things which you don't know. I also don't know. She also doesn't know. She also doesn't know. So in the interview, we are not trying to test your knowledge. Even if you have not heard of Kautilya or whatever and whatever, it doesn't matter. But by interviewing a person, we are scanning that person. We are trying to understand you. And what is the level of commitment and how honest you are? All your knowledge, etc., has been tested in the prelims and mains and all that. This interview is nothing about knowledge. Even if you don't know 100 questions, you say you don't know. That does not really matter. But they only want to see your attitude, how you react. Because when you are talking to her, I am constantly observing you. You may not be aware, but she and I would be constantly observing you, how you are talking to her, how you are reacting. And when the interview is over, then we all discuss. I will ask her how much marks she want to give, I ask her how much marks she want to give. Supposing she says 80%, she says 85%. Then I say, no, I didn't find her honest enough, then I'll be only 60%. So there should not be wide variation between the assessment of different members. So you have to present yourself in such a fashion. First, the honesty and the capacity to admit that I don't know. You may not be knowing many things. The interview board members, they themselves don't know many things which you know and they don't know.
They also said it long back.
Because, this form of Pilates, I had not heard of. But last night I just tried to find out what is this and all that. Then I heard of this in 1920s, when the Joseph Fellow had started for rehabilitation of war veterans and all that, and Second World War. So there are many things which I don't know. He doesn't know, interview board member and chairman, nobody knows. But they will purposely ask you these questions, just to see how you react. I think you prepare well on these things your hobbies that you have written, and you know, this Kathak, etc. You know, I mean, apart from knowing Kathak dance, you also have to know how it has originated, what is the background of it. I mean, you know, dancing is another thing, but how Kathak has originated, what is the genesis of it, that also you have to know, because somebody may just start asking you from the times it is started. So you have to, obviously, of course you may be knowing, but you just prepare yourself for that. How did it start? And what are other different forms? And what is the difference between this Kathak and then some Odissi or Bharatanatyam and all that? And somebody can go into a lot of details.
Yes. Are you aware of all this?
I have made my notes for the hobbies and
yeah,
everything.
Yeah, because...
But I think the army questions are where my views are certain views are very rigid. I think I need to tone them down a bit.
Don't lose your originality also.
Yeah.
It's not mean that you have to lie there or you don't have to
because
lose
honesty,
your
as sir said, is important.
So don't lose your originality. Just like a little bit of toning down is more than sufficient. Like you said, because you've always heard that opinion, you will have that opinion.
Yes,
we've all had that opinion. So it's okay. That's fine. Just that now you have to tone it down a little. That's it. Don't lose your originality. It's perfectly fine. Don't worry on that part.